Yo, we're here. Yeah, beautiful sunset in the distance here in Vineland, New Jersey. So let's head into the Ramada because we're gonna be staying the whole weekend. Decent. Let's see what the view's like, y'all. Okay. The view's decent. I mean, it's not great, but it is what it is. There's a pretty church across the street. Look at the... It has, like, those, the, like, roof. Looks like one of those buildings in Russia. Looks very cool. And the bathroom, it's all right. Not the nicest hotel I've been to, but it's decent. What's up, guys? So this is one of three restaurants in the hotel. Look at it, it's nice. It's basically steakhouse and sushi. So they have like steak right here. That's considered well done. Is it really? Nah. Yeah, that looks well done. All the sushi. Y'all, we're at Wawa right now. We just had to stop here because we don't have any water at the hotel. So we're here at Wawa. Guys, this is like a brand new Wawa. Everything here just looks new. This place probably wasn't built too long ago. Maybe like a few months ago, maybe. 6:13 in the morning, guys. Again, gotta wake up early today because the whole reason why we're down here is because my brother has a bunch of soccer tournaments down in South Jersey. So that's why we're down here. And the soccer tournament's about 45 minutes from here in a town called Hamilton. But we're in Vineland, like I said. So I don't know about 45 minutes. It's probably like half an hour because I know where Hamilton is. I've been there and I know where we are. So it's probably about half an hour. But yeah. So we got to get up early because this game starts at like 7. But I don't mind waking up early. I just hate sports. I don't hate all sports. I shouldn't say that. But like, I don't know. I do not like travel sports because I feel like they're so time consuming. And now I hate soccer so much because he has to travel so far for freaking soccer. Like, I prefer town sports. Like, when you have, like, say you have, like, Montclair High School playing, like, Clifton High School in football. Like, that's fine with me, but not like traveling across the freaking country to play sports. We're gonna get back in. And we're gonna head downstairs to the lobby. Apparently, they got free breakfast here, which is weird because they have an IHOP, but I'm not sure where it is, so we'll have to check. Over there is where all the soccer fields are. And obviously, you know me, I don't play soccer. So instead, since we're in the Pine Barrens right now, I'm gonna do some off-roading in the Pine Barrens, minus the ATV.
We don't make hybrids. And we don't make luxury sedans. We only make one thing. The ultimate driving machine.
And before you even think that I'm over-exaggerating, nah, people really do steal bikes. I've had two bikes stolen in my life and a scooter. And it was like it wasn't like a good electric scooter. It was like a cheap Razor e-scooter. It wasn't like one of those fancy ones you see that you can like rent in big cities. Nah, it was a crappy one, but still. Yeah. One of my bikes was stolen at an elementary school near my house. I was just chilling there. Obviously wasn't paying attention. Somebody took the bike. The next time, it was in my driveway. And in the middle of the night, somebody took it. and then the scooter. I'm not even kidding. I literally parked the scooter just to go to the bathroom in the woods. I'm not even kidding. And I come out and it's gone. So yeah, I've definitely learned my lesson, but the second one I was not expecting because it was at my house, but whatever. Always carry a bike rack with you. Off-roading in the Pine Barrens. Not really. I'm riding on a freaking bike, but still.
Turn left to stay.
Guys, I've never seen a church with so many flags, but the actual reason why there's so many flags is these 660 flags represent the number of veterans who die by their own hand every month. Jesus. That's sad. I really do feel for them because, you know, a lot of them, when they come back from war, they get like PTSD, where they're like very, like, I guess nervous, you know, and very paranoid about everything, and I guess kind of out of it. And I guess their behavior is kind of like what it was during the war, or they're just traumatized. So I guess a lot of them do end their lives, which is sad. Guys, if you have any suicidal thoughts, call the suicide hotline. I can't remember the number exactly, but look it up. I think it was over there. It's 1-800-273 something something. Continuing our off-roading, we are right in the back of Walmart, and we are off-roading by Walmart. right. No, I'm kidding. We're gonna go back into the woods soon. And the rainstorm has begun. Gosh, a lot of rain. This is beautiful, guys. We have not had a good rainstorm in forever, it seems like. It just doesn't rain enough, to be completely honest. And I'm not just saying that. Like, New Jersey's been very dry recently. Like, I think there was actually this summer a few weeks where it just hadn't rained at all. And that happened to be during the heat wave. So we were actually in an actual drought, according to the weather service. But it's good to see that it's raining. Usually I don't say that, but right now I'm happy it's raining. Saturday night dinner right here in the heart of Millville, New Jersey. So I've heard about Millville, and I know, but it's my first time actually coming to Millville, and it's a really nice, like, it's a really cute small town. It's not really small, it's actually a decent sized town. But yeah, there's like a lot of restaurants. There's a movie theater right there. Yeah, but it's like a really nice, beautiful town. But the sad part about this place is how many abandoned storefronts there are, and like a lot of abandoned buildings, which is sad. I mean, look, abandoned. 6 abandoned buildings in a row. That's sad. Cause look at this, it's like such a pretty place, but you have so many abandoned storefronts. It sucks. Cause it is genuinely a nice town. And it has beautiful architecture. Like, this place has a lot of potential. Residential streets are over here. They're not really special, but yeah. The downtown is very nice. I just wish there was more. I wish there was just more businesses here, and more restaurants and like businesses to replace those empty storefronts. Yeah, but it's beautiful, as you can see. Very diverse community as well. I like Millville. All right, y'all, we got the chimichangas, the refried beans, and the rice. Look at this, this John is delicious. It looks amazing, guys. I'm like so ready to dig in. 7:56 in the morning, and it is Sunday. As you can see, it's a little bit hazy today. It's been very hazy in the mornings around here. Yesterday, the road was completely covered in haze when we had to bring my brother to a soccer tournament around 7 o'clock in the morning. But today, I woke up around 7. I went back to bed and woke up around 7:30. So, yeah. And today, I actually got a shower today, which is good because I didn't shower yesterday. I woke up at like 5:45 yesterday. So, had a little bit more sleep today. But unfortunately, my brother's not going to be playing in the soccer tournament because he had a minor head injury yesterday. And, you know, And we don't want to risk it. Like, if he gets hurt today, you know, who knows what's going to happen. It could be a whole lot worse. But, yeah. I don't know what's going to happen. So, our plan might be... We were kind of planning on it, but we weren't 100% sure. We might have been going to Atlantic City, but I don't think we're going to do that now. I think we'll just go somewhere in the Pine Barrens. Maybe go to, like, a lake or something around here. But, yeah. There's a Mississippi tag right there. Thank you, someone from Mississippi, for visiting New Jersey. I appreciate that. Somebody from Texas is visiting New Jersey as well. Somebody from South Carolina is visiting New Jersey. They're probably all going to Atlantic City, but they're probably staying here because all the hotels in Atlantic City are super expensive. The ones around here are not cheap either. This was like $200 a night. That's not cheap, but I think hotels jack up their prices on weekends. I'm kind of like jealous that we had to stay at the Ramada and not the Wingate or the Hampton. Like, look at how much nicer those hotels look. But this one's average, so I can't complain. It's not like we're in some like sketchy motel, you know what I'm saying? We are in the literal middle of nowhere, guys, in the Pine Barrens. We're just on this dirt road. I don't know what to say about this. This is the type of place where the Italian mafia hides their bodies. Because there is Italian mafia down in South Jersey, so or if like you have the Italian mafia in South Philly, they're gonna come down here. Maybe we'll run into the Jersey Devil. Guys, this song is literally on the radio on like every freaking station. Like, there was one time I even changed the station and they were playing the song. This is like, this song's everywhere. It's kind of getting annoying, low-key. Not even low-key. This song was like an 80s song that wasn't even popular in the 80s, but Stranger Things played it. Now everyone's listening to it now. Crazy. All right, guys, we're on our way to Basto Village, which is an abandoned town in the middle of the Pine Barrens. All right, so we're here at Basto Village, as y'all can see. All right, we're at Basto Village, as you guys can see. And I think this is where I'm going to finish up our tour. The first thing I just want to do is I just want to kind of explain this place. I'm going to have a video posted here, and I think I'm going to post it in October. Because for all the new subscribers, or the people that don't know, every single October, I kind of keep a haunted or like exploring theme to my channel. So if you came here because of food or music, I'm sorry, but yeah, you're not going to get much of that in October. So this building right here, I'm guessing this was, yeah, a place where they stored the tools. This might have been where they kept the horses, maybe, like in here. It seems a little bit small for the horses, though. This is like the gear they would have for the horses. Yeah. And this town was, this is like back in the 1800s. This is like forever ago. This is where people would come for the iron, because iron was big back in Pine Barrens back in the day. But historically, in this part of New Jersey at least, historically this area has just been like untraveled or like uninhabited, because there's the sand around here, like the soil is not very good for growing, at least. So you can really only grow like cranberries or blueberries. Like, see what I'm saying? Like, hey, let me just dig up a little bit, let me show you what the soil is like. See, it's not like, it's not good soil for growing. It's not rich soil, you know. It's sandy soil. So it's the only thing you can really grow are blueberries and cranberries, which New Jersey produces a lot of that. But especially down in this part of New Jersey, there's a lot of cranberry and blueberry places. But New Jersey is an agricultural state, especially in like central Jersey, where the soil is a bit better. But around here, you couldn't really grow much. And that's why historically not that many people lived in this part of the state. So this right here, right in there, there's some people in there right now. They kind of look a little creepy, I ain't gonna lie, but but this was a general store. I walked inside. So if you guys are still gonna be watching my channel in October, you'll see the video. So yeah, this is beautiful. So you might be wondering what this building is, and here's the answer right here. The corn crib. The corn crib is not what you might think it is. The place where baby corn takes a nap. The corn crib was used to dry and store ears of corn to remove kernels from the cob, and a process known as shelling. the mechanicalism for shelling powered by the gristmill water turbine. It was located on the second floor. The large tunnel-like operating allowed wagons to drive straight into the building where workers would unload the ears of corn. The open slats helped air circulation for the drying process. After shelling corn kernels, they were sent by conveyor belts high above your head to the adjacent gristmill, where they were ground into cornmeal. So yeah, so they would use corn for a lot of stuff, and so this is where they would do it. Are you fine? All right, so we're gonna head into this building right here, and I think we'll just end the tour up here. God, my pants are like gonna fall off. I forgot to bring a belt down. I didn't pack a belt, so my pants are like gonna fall down. Like, I'm legit sagging right now. So yeah, this, I don't know what this is used for. I'm sure there's someone that's gonna tell me, but as you can see, oh, I guess we could go down here. Yeah, as you can see, oh my gosh, this wood is like really sketching me out, guys. All right, so that's gonna finish it up for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Look at my background. I feel like I'm filming in like some Amish farm in Pennsylvania. But make sure to like, subscribe, and God bless all you guys.